Hello and welcome to another Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, you are going to learn how to create PDF reports using the available PDF application within Scriptcase. But before I begin, I will show you what the end result of this video will be like. As you can see, I have here already a ready-made PDF report, which includes a header, a logo with a date. We also have a page number at the bottom right. As the page content or PDF content, we have a price list of items or products within the main body. Okay, so to create a new PDF application, we need to access Scriptcase and select the new application. And once we've done that, we can then select PDF report. We can then select a table. And for this example, I will again use the products table. So once I have that selected, I can then within the SQL statement change or modify the query. And I want only the product ID, the product name, and also the unit price fields. I will remove all the other fields. I will leave the default name, which has been provided, and everything else can also remain. Now then, when I'm ready, I'm going to go ahead and click the create button. Okay, so now if I run the PDF application as it is, you will see that I have a single product ID, the product name, and its price available. I do notice that this is a single product per page. If I scroll, I will have a single product with relevant details on a single PDF page. Okay, so let's start customizing this PDF, returning back to Scriptcase. And then within the PDF report settings, the first thing I will do is change the type from records per page to records per line. And then we're gonna run it again and see the difference. You can see now that all the records now come stacked. So now I will want to change the arrangement. I can do this by accessing the layout PDF within Scriptcase and the left menu. We can see here that we have the layout PDF selected and we have a little box here on the right. Now notice when I click the body of the PDF, I have some PDF report settings which I can adjust on the right here, which are some of the settings which are available on the settings. And I also have a font and background options where I can make some adjustments to how the PDF looks. So we're going to leave those as they are for the time being and concentrate on our fields here in the center. So now notice that I can move these fields around. And you can see already that I've included an extra field, which was the supplier ID, which I also wanted to remove. So I can either go ahead and click the delete button here, or within the layout PDF and then interface, I will also have the fields available for the body, which I am now viewing. And I can also remove the field from here by again clicking the delete cell and clicking OK. So now let's return back to the layout PDF and we can again adjust the fields that we have here. So I will have product name, which I can then drag into the positions that I want. We have then the product ID, which I actually want to have first, and then the unit price. So I'll place the unit price to the right, the product ID I will place to the left, and then the product name I will place just next to that. So now if I go ahead and run the PDF application again, we can see the changes within the application. And that is only now by making those adjustments within this layout PDF option. Okay, so now I will go ahead and make some slight adjustments to how the data is actually displayed within the PDF application. So the first thing I want to do is I want to expand the fields folder, which I have here, and there I will expand that. And then I will select the product ID field. Now for the ID field, I want it to be completed with zeros. At the moment, it is only one number. And what I can do now is use the field mask and place some X's in here. So I'm gonna place four X's. This will then add four zeros as a total. And we can see that now applied within our PDF. So next up, we then also want to adjust the unit price. And for the unit price, I want to display the currency format within the PDF. So if I run that again, I will now have the currency displayed for my currency field. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is change some further settings within the layout PDF. And here, one of the first things we want to do is change the line height. So at the moment, looking at the PDF, they are quite closely stacked together. So if I now come back to Scriptcase and change the line height to 6, for instance, and run it again, we will see that we will have an increased space between each product listed. Okay, so then back into Scriptcase, we're going to do some further options, which now will access the layout PDF and then the interface option, which we had seen a moment ago. Now here we can see we have each item listed that we have displayed within our PDF. Now to the left here, notice that we have an edit cell icon next to each item. So here, for instance, I will take the product name. I will edit this. I will first of all select the bold, because here I can change the font, how the color also. Let's this time change this to a red. And the font and so forth, we will leave as they are. Width and alignment, we can also change here. And we also have the option to display this field or actually hide it. So I'm happy with that now. Let's go ahead and update that. Now, if I run the PDF application again, we should now see our product names in red. Okay, so now that we have the whole body part, let's go ahead and include the header as well as the footer within our report. Now, I need to enable the header and footer within the PDF layout first. So I can do that either within the settings, and then within the settings here, I can select here the boxes, display header and display footer. So I'll go ahead and save that. The alternative method is within the layout PDF. And again, here on the right hand options, we have the display header and display footer once again. Now below this, we can also change the height of the header and footer that we want to have displayed. So now that the header and footer is enabled, we can also see it now displayed within our layout PDF option here. And what we can do now is add some further fields. So I want to first of all add a logo, the page number at the bottom, as well as then the date that we have when the PDF is viewed. Now to quickly add some fields within our PDF report, to the top of the layout PDF up here, you can see a little icon. If I click this, it will display the fields that we have currently available within the PDF report. So within the left-hand menu, we have some special fields available, which we can then drag and drop within the PDF layout. So we want the current page displayed within our footer, which we then need to drag into our footer and then place where we want it displayed. And then we also want to have the system date displayed in our header. So I go ahead and drag that up here. And then I will go ahead and run the PDF application again. And we can now see that we have our date added as well as the page number added to each PDF report. Okay, going back into Scriptcase, we still have two fields that we want to add, and that is then the logo, and we can also add a label or title for the PDF. So I'm going to go ahead this time and create two new fields. So on the left-hand side, selecting fields and a new field, I'll indicate a quantity of 2, go next. I will provide a name of logo and then also title. For logo, I'll change the type to HTML image, and title I will leave as text. Click create, and then for the title I will then place in here some very basic text. For the logo, I will go ahead and add an image to use for the application. So here I will select the Scriptcase logo, I will add that, and again I will go ahead and run the application so we see what it looks like now, and we can see that the logo has been placed multiple times within the PDF. So now back within Scriptcase, I come back here to the interface. And I can see here that the logo has been placed within the body content. I will go ahead and delete that and then access the header. And here I can have the system date. Here I will select to add a new field, and I will change the field to the logo. I will then add an extra field. And again, I need to change it again, logo. And the second field I will select as title and save that. And now within the layout PDF, I can again make adjustments to where these fields are positioned, run the application and see the final results. So for the title, which we still don't have displayed yet, we will go back into Scriptcase, and now we'll access the interface option. Should notice that the title has also been added, just like the logo previously. So I will go ahead and delete that cell also from the body. Access the header again. Now for the title, we will change this option to the special field and indicate a label, and then provide a title for our PDF report. When we are ready, we can go ahead and run our application again. and view the difference now with the title being displayed within the header. Again, we need to make some final adjustments to the layout, and we can do that again within the layout PDF. Increase the space between the logo and the header, run it again, and we have a complete PDF report. Now to conclude, we can modify the behavior of the PDF to be downloaded directly within the PDF report settings. Changing the PDF destination from browser to download will change how the PDF runs. If I run the application again, the browser will automatically go to download the new PDF file. Alternative option is also to indicate the file name that will be provided for the report. For instance, here I can change the file name that will be saved of the PDF application to sample, and it will then be called sample.pdf each time it is downloaded. Now let's create a new report PDF application to list products by categories this time. So I will again select the new application and again select the PDF report application. This time I will use the categories table, and here I only want the category ID and the category name field to be included. Once ready, click create, and then we can run our application to see what it looks like. Now for this application, I only want to display one record per category per page. So we see here we have at the moment one category displayed, and that's how we want to keep it. So now let's go back into Scriptcase, and what we want to do now is arrange the fields side by side. So in layout PDF, I will arrange the fields side by side. So I have then the category ID and then the category name. Now let's run this again and see what it looks like. Now we have the category ID and then the category name listed. Now let's list the products to each category below this. Now back in Scriptcase, first I need to create a new field of the type subselect. So I will indicate one extra subselect, and here indicate that it's for the categories. Click create when ready. Now here I will then select the connection that we are using, and then provide the products table, and then below that we see that we have then our SQL statement already created for us on table selection. Now here we can then also go ahead and change the information that is displayed. So I will go ahead and make some adjustments so that I only have certain information displayed within the list. Once you've finished editing, you can go ahead and run the application, and we can see what it looks like now. Now at the moment we have a bit of a jumble, so what we need to do is modify our select again, because we only want to display the products from each category. So now we need to add here a where clause. So once we're ready and our statement has been added, we then want to go back to the layout PDF and adjust where our new information is being stored. So here I have then the product name, the categories being added, the unit price, as well as then the unit total. So I'm going to adjust them here slightly and then run our application once we are ready. We can now see a list of our products with each of the categories. Of course, we can make further adjustments here so that we reduce some of the space that we have here, as well as then within the category SQL, we can also make some further adjustments that we change the distance between the rows. So here, if I change to 6, for instance, and run the PDF application again, we can now see the difference and see that our products are now closer together. And again, let's go ahead back to the layout PDF and adjust slightly our information here and run it one more time, and we should have now a much cleaner layout. Now, if you want to add a background image to the PDF report, you can do so by accessing settings. Ideally, this is added to pages with a predefined layout. And now here, we would then select a PDF background image, which we can then add to the background of our PDF application. So if I add something random now, run it again, we will now see that we have a background within our PDF. Depending on the size of the image, it is important to add the height and the width. For instance, you need to provide the dimensions of the page. This example is great to help you in the creation of bills and receipts which require this kind of information and layout. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.